Self-awareness, the key to taking care of your mental health and well-being. Self-awareness is another one of those terms that gets thrown around quite a bit in the psychology world. So what exactly is it?
Being self-aware and mentally ill at the same time is so exhausting. Because not only do I know when I'm being self-destructive, I watch myself do it anyway.
Your mental health and your well-being is the most important thing in the world. Nobody else is going to maintain that for you because everybody else is focused on their own. If you want to spend as long on this planet as humanly possible, you need to create a good environment for yourself. And that involves you taking a look around at the things that you're doing with your life and the people that you're hanging around with. Because if you're not where you want to be, it will be because of one of those two things.
Are you looking for ways to take care of your well-being? Here are my top 5 tips for your mental health. The first one is journaling. It's a great way to release tension that happens in the mind. The second one is meditation. This is actually a great way to release tension that happens in the body, especially when you struggle with stress and anxiety and other mental health disorders. The third one is learning to reframe our thoughts through audio journaling. When we talk out loud, we can identify discrepancies as well as errors in our thinking. The fourth one is reading. If you struggle with your mental health, healthy escapism is a great way to deal with difficult emotions. I love to read fiction books, but you can read whatever it is that you identify with. The last one is learning to say no and set boundaries. Our boundaries are limits that we put in place to take care of our mental well-being, so practice saying no.
I have stopped listening to the news. It's been about a year now. I mean, I used to be a news girl. I used to be a morning show girl. I would listen to morning shows, get myself updated on what is happening in the country. But then it got to a time I realized that all the things I was hearing early in the morning to get myself prepared for the day were all negative and discouraging and disappointing, especially in this country. And it got to a point it was gradually affecting my thought process, because in my mind, if everything is not working in the country, why am I working so hard? Why am I even bothering myself? Listening to all the negative news early in the morning when you wake up and you are geared for work and you hear all this disappointing news by our leaders, I was like, no. I have to protect my peace. I have to protect my mental health. And as someone who loves to be in a state of positivity all the time, it was the best decision for me. I am also very conscious about the things I watch, the people I associate myself with, and who I talk to, what I watch, what I listen to in a day. And so on the internet, the people I follow are very crucial to my life. The people you follow are very crucial to your life, because in the end, they will be a reflection of your thought process. They will be a reflection of your personality. They will be a reflection of who you are. You might not see the impact now, but you'll be surprised. Don't just follow anyone for following sake, because you keep seeing them every blessed day, and what they do indirectly affects you, whether you like it or not. I am one person who always sets standards. I always set standards for myself, at work, church, here on the internet. Everywhere, I set standards. Because when you don't set standards for yourself, you just do anything. You wake up and do anything. Somebody says something and you are in. You make certain decisions based on what people say and what people think, what you see, what you are influenced by. You don't just wake up and go with the flow because that is what everybody is doing. No. What is your priority in life? What is for you? So if you're a content creator, what are the standards you set for yourself and your audience? What are the standards you set for yourself and on your page? What are the standards you set for yourself and the brands you work with? So you need to set those standards. Otherwise, you always find yourself making decisions out of foolishness. And if there's anyone who won't respect your standards, what are you doing with the person? Just cut them off. You can call me the queen of blocking. I would block you and your entire generation if you try to disrespect my standards, because there's no way I'm going to lower myself and compromise on your behalf. No. I always say that I am blessed with wonderful and amazing friends all my life. I really can't relate to bad friends relationship, because the moment I realize you are somebody I cannot vibe with, I'll just... You get it? So there's no way we will move on from acquaintance to friendship if at the very initial stage, I found out that you were not somebody I can really be a friend with. You get it? And last but not least, I consider it that I am alone in the middle of the river. I paddle my own canoe. So I don't expect anything from anyone. I don't expect anybody to do anything for me. When I post a video, I don't expect that it will go viral, because when I put myself in that state, it puts me in a relaxation mode and gets me prepared for everything. It gets me prepared for happiness, for disappointment, for sadness, for every kind of emotion, because I haven't been in expectancy of anything. And so if a celebration comes, I am prepared. If disappointment comes, I am also prepared. So I don't expect anything from anybody at all. Yeah, so these are just some random facts about me and how I protect my mental health. It is very, very crucial, and I believe everyone should find something that would keep your mental health safe.
I will always choose you.
Wish you could trade eyes with me, because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things out of focus, you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watching, they all adore you. Lately, wish you could trade eyes with me, because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things out of focus, you, but when you're in the room, they notice.